Hi. So today we are going to start with the second session of salary, and today we are going to discuss about the allowances. But before going into allowances, let's understand what do I mean by allowances. Usually allowances are the additional benefits which are given by the company to its employees. But in most of the cases, these benefits can be either monetary or in non-monetary nature. The benefits which are usually given in the monetary nature are known as allowances, and non-monetary benefits are usually known as perquisites. So in this session, we are going to discuss about the allowances, and in next session, we'll be discuss about the perquisites. So when I say allowances, allowances are usually bifurcated into three parts. One, it can either be fully taxable. Second, it can be partially taxable. Or third, those allowances which are fully exempt. Which means, in case of fully taxable allowances, if those kind of allowances are given by your company to its employees, those allowances will be fully taxable on the salary. In case of partially taxable allowances, those allowances will be taxable but based upon certain conditions. And fully exempted allowances will be fully deductible, or that will not be taxable irrespective of the amount of allowances given by the company. Let's talk about partially exempt, partially taxable allowances. First, that is entertainment allowance. Now, when I talk about entertainment allowance are the allowances given for the purpose of entertainment of the employees. This allowance is bifurcated into two parts. One, those entertainment allowances which are given to the government employees by the government, and second, to the private employees by its own respective company. If the allowances is given by the government to government employees, in that case, it would be exempted up to certain portion. The exempted amount will be whichever less of the following. First, it is the actual allowance which you have received. Second, 20% of your basic salary. And the third one is 5,000 rupees. Out of these three, whichever is the lowest amount would be exempted and the rest of the amount will be taxable. Let me make you understand by giving you an example. Let's say your salary is 1 lakh rupees and the allowances which are provided to you by your company is 10,000 rupees. So let's check this three conditions. Condition number one, actual allowance received, that is 10,000 rupees. Condition number two, 20% of your basic salary. So your salary is 1 lakh rupees. 20% of 1 lakh rupees would be 20,000. And point number three, 5,000 rupees flat. So one, 10,000. Second was 20,000. And third was 5,000. The lowest of the following is 5,000 rupees. And hence, out of the allowance of 10,000 which you have received, 5,000 rupees would be exempted. And the remaining of the 5,000 would be taxable in your head. But this was about the government employee. In case of private companies, the whole amount of allowance, entertainment allowance, which you are receiving will be taxable. In case of those employees, no deduction, no exemption is allowable. The whole allowance are taxable. Let's talk about next allowances, that is house rent allowances. House rent allowances, which means government provides you rent, amount of rent to be, to stay or to be in certain house. Which means if you are from another city and if you are shifting in this particular city, in that case, your company will provide you allowances which can compensate your rent. Now, in case of house rent allowances, two parts, it is bifurcated into two parts. Point number one, if you are staying in metro city, what I mean by metro city, it will cover Mumbai, Delhi, Chennai and Kolkata. Now, if you are living in the metro city, in that case, whichever lowest of the following would be exempted. Point number one, actual HRA, that is actual house rent allowance which you have received. Point number two, the amount of rent which you are paying to your landlord minus 10% of your salary. And point number three, 50% of your salary. Whichever is less from this following three points would be exempted. However, if you are not living in a metro city and you are living in any other city, like let's say Ahmedabad, in that case, following would be exempted. Point number one, actual HRA received. Point number two, rent paid to landlord by you minus 10% of your salary. And point number three, 40% of your salary. The only difference between if you are living in a metro city or if you are living in non-metro cities, in case of metro city, your point number three would be 50% of your salary, and in case of other cities, it would be 40% of the salary. The remaining of the conditions are going to remain same. So this was partly taxable allowances. Let's talk about some other partly taxable allowances. One is education expense. For the purpose of education of your children, if your company is paying you certain amount, in that case, 100 rupees per month per child is exempt. So let's say, sir, a question might come, what if I have 3 children? So in that case, government has said 100 rupees per month per child is exempt, but that is available up to 2 children only. So in case of 3 children also, the amount of exemption which you are going to get would be 200 rupees per month. In case of hostel allowances, it would be 300 rupees per month per child. Again, the condition is it is maximum up to 2 children. In case of conveyance, if your company is paying. So if the company is paying you conveyance, in that case, it would be exempt up to 1600 rupees per month. And in case of handicap employees, it would be 3200 per month. So what do I mean by the exempted amount? Let me give an example and you will be understanding. Let's say if your company is paying you conveyance of 3000 rupees per month. And if you're not an handicap employee, in that case, 1600 rupees are exempt. So out of 3000, 1600 would be exempted and the remaining of the 1400 would be taxable in the hand of an assessor. So that was all about partly taxable allowances. Now let's talk about fully taxable allowances, which means those allowances which are fully taxable irrespective of your employer, your age or any of your job. So these are the allowances which are completely taxable, which includes traveling allowances for the purpose of traveling if your company providing you allowances, or helper allowances for the purpose of uniform if they are providing you allowances, or lunch allowances, or in case of foreign allowances. So for the purpose of foreign tour, if they are providing you certain allowances, that will also be completely taxable. In case of uniform allowances they are providing, which means for the purpose of buying uniform, if they are providing you allowances, those allowances would also be completely taxable. There are certain other allowances which are also covered under fully taxable allowances. And the last, fully exempted allowances, which means irrespective of your status, these allowances would be completely exempt. It is one, foreign allowances. Now someone will ask, sir, you have said foreign allowances in case of taxable fully taxable allowances also. Why you are saying those are fully exempt? So please note this, foreign allowances given to government employees are fully exempt, but foreign allowances given to non-government employees would be fully taxable. Second is allowances given to High Court or Supreme Court judges, and third, allowances given to UNO employees, that is United Nations employees. This kind of allowances are fully exempted. So I guess I made myself clear regarding to allowances which are fully taxable, fully exempt or partially taxable. In next session, we'll be discussing about the perquisites. Thank you.